Would you like to learn about threat modeling?
If so, this video is for you. Hi, my name's Mike Gibbs. I'm the CEO of GoCloud Careers. And in today's video, we're going to talk about threat modeling. We will talk about what is threat modeling. We will talk about why threat modeling is important. We will talk about the process of threat modeling. And we will even talk about some threat modeling tools. So to begin, what is threat modeling? Well, threat modeling is really a proactive approach where an organization can look at various situations to determine the risks to their organization. So if we know the environment and we think about all the potential risks and threats that we actually have, that's really threat modeling. So threat modeling is all about identifying vulnerabilities, assessing risks, corrective measures, and trying to find a strategy to reduce an organization's risk. Now, threat modeling is going to be critical because if we don't understand the threats, we really have no way of knowing how we're going to fix these threats. And that's why threat modeling is an absolute critical knowledge set for the cloud security architect or the security architect, or quite frankly, anyone working in cybersecurity. So let's talk about what we're getting out of this. If we really carefully examine our systems, and in order for threat modeling, we're going to have to carefully examine our systems. And then we can think of the various types of attacks and threats that could be used against us. Now we're in a better position to defend ourselves. So we typically get much better system insights. Now, after 25 years as an architect, I can tell you sometimes organizations don't have the best documentation. They don't have the best charts and documents explaining their systems. But in the process of threat modeling, you often have to create it. So that gives many people enhanced insight into their systems. Now, in the process of really evaluating the threats that exist of an organization, you're going to have to go to various stakeholders and look at various applications that are used by various teams and various other things as well. So that typically improves the collaboration in an organization, which also tends to enhance the security posture. And threat modeling is all about risk mitigation and risk prioritization. Obviously, we can't mitigate all risks, but at least if we look at the threats and we model them, we can figure out what are the biggest risks that we actually have to solve. So let's talk about how we actually do threat modeling or the threat modeling process. The first thing we have to do is to identify our assets. We have to determine critical elements such as data, intellectual property, or system reliability or availability, or what is that big thing? What is our asset that we actually have to protect? Now, in a perfect world, the systems are already diagrammed, but here we may need to create data flow diagrams, pretty significant views of what's talking to what, because we can't lock down anything if we don't know what's talking to what. Now, here we typically have to analyze the various threats. We're going to look at our diagrams. We're going to assess specific threat types, and then we'll quantify the risks using basically risk establishment methodologies that we typically use in all organizations. And that what we're going to do is prioritize the biggest risks to fix. And then after we figure out what the biggest risks are, we're going to identify those. So and then we'll identify fixes for them, and then we'll implement the fixes, or the engineers will implement the fixes, and then we'll test to make sure they work. So how do organizations typically do this? Well, there's a couple methods that we could use and a couple of tools for threat modeling. Easiest, we basically use what's called the CIA method, which is based on confidentiality, integrity, and availability. And in this environment, we're identifying sensitive customer data, for example. We're looking at operational or proprietary data and the integrity of the data. And then we're looking at essential web services or essential business services and keep their availability. That's one approach. Now, Microsoft has a great framework. It's called the Stride framework. Many people have used it throughout years. And that was a framework developed by Microsoft, and it covers things like spoofing or tampering and information disclosure, denial of service, elevation of privileges. And it generates data flow diagrams, and it conducts a threat analysis. And it's one of the most popular tools in threat modeling. Now, another one that's widely used is the PASTA. And PASTA is the process for attack simulation and threat analysis. And that is a comprehensive framework that's out there. And it follows a 7-step process for the most part, which deals with the objectives and the scope of what you're actually dealing with. It combines vulnerability assessments, threat modeling, and it really concludes with some risk and impact scoring. So this is a widely used framework, the PASTA framework. There's also an open source framework called VAST, which is this visual, agile, and simple threat modeling tool. And it provides scalable, adaptable approaches that are going to be suitable for any part of an organization or a scope of an organization. This is going to produce benchmark data that's going to really facilitate reliable comparisons, effective risk management. So what you can see is threat modeling is really about understanding the challenges and risks that we have. And in order to truly understand, it involves really understanding everything we have on our systems. What's talking to what needs to talk to what, and then we're using various tools to further reduce our risk. This is what threat modeling is, and it's absolutely critical for security architects, cloud security architects, and other technology professionals. If you would like to become a security architect or a cloud architect or an AI architect or a enterprise architect or any other kind of architect, join us in a free architecture webinar. We hold one at least once a week. The link to register for these webinars is in the description of this video. We will go over the architect role. We'll talk about the skills you need, and it'll be on Zoom, so we'll answer any questions you may have about your future architecture career. If you've enjoyed this video, please give it a like. Subscribe and hit the bell to be notified of new videos to assist you in your IT architecture career, whether it be cloud architecture, enterprise architecture, security architecture, network architecture, or enterprise architecture, or any other kind of architecture. This is Mike Gibbs signing off for now, and I look forward to seeing you in another video. Take care.